हरे कृष्णा, आई बी स्पीकिंग अबाउट श्रील गौर गोविंद स्वामी महाराज. हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस श्रील गौर गोविंद स्वामी महाराज अपियर्ड ऑन द 2nd of September इन द गौरबदा ईयर 443, दैट इज 1929 AD, इन ओरिसा, इंडिया. बोथ हिज पेरेंट्स वर डिवोटीज ऑफ कृष्णा एंड जगन्नाथ, एज वर देयर एंसेस्टर्स up to the time of Sri Shyamananda Prabhu. His mother's family were the famous Kirtaniyas of Gadaigiri. Thus, most of His Divine Grace's child and boyhood was spent in Gadaigiri in the company of his uncles and maternal grandfather, having kirtan and worshipping their ancient family deity, Sri Gopalji. He was never attached to play, but rather spent his time reading Srimad Bhagavatam and Sri Chaitanya Charitamrit and singing Hare Krishna. In April 1974, on Ram Navami, the day of the holy appearance of Lord Ramachandra, His Divine Grace left his family to search for Sri Guru. He was now 45 years old, but had since childhood the desire to accept the renounced order of life, sannyas, and preach the message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was already acquainted with many sadhus in Orissa and throughout the rest of India, but was not satisfied by them. He travelled on foot and by train around northern India for about 5 months, stopping at every temple, monastery, an institution where there might be a sadhu. Arriving at last in Sri Vrindavan Dham, he met His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada on the 15th of September 1974. Among the first things Srila Prabhupada asked him was whether or not he had taken sannyas. Srila Prabhupada said, "I will give you sannyas." Within a short time, Srila Prabhupada initiated him, giving him Harinam and Diksha and the name Sri Gaur Govind Das, and sent him to preach in Orissa. On Ram Navami 1975, during the opening of Sri Sri Krishna Balaram Mandir in Vrindavan, 1 year after he had left home, Sri Gaur Govind Das was given sannyas by Srila Prabhupada. Thus, Srila Gaur Govind Swami came back to Orissa and gradually, after much hardships, opened the temple that Srila Prabhupada had envisioned in Bhubaneswar. He also translated Srila Prabhupada's books into the Orient language. From 1985 through 1996, His Divine Grace Srila Gaur Govind Swami preached throughout the world and accepted disciples. Thus, he executed the 3 instructions Srila Prabhupada gave him. Though he had problems walking after an operation, His Divine Grace Srila Gaur Govind Swami travelled extensively and preached energetically. He spoke with the force and firmness of a bullet, yet was soft at heart. He stressed the value of purity and simplicity, emphasizing the importance of pure chanting and encouraging everyone to earn for Sadhu Sangh, the association of pure devotees. He warned against duplicity and the pollution of that Kali had infiltrated into the minds of people in this age. He always made it a point to support everything that he said with reference from the Shastra and present that everyone is in Srila Prabhupada's books. You only have to extract it. The centennial of Srila Prabhupada's divine appearance was celebrated in 1996. In the evening of the appearance day of His Divine Grace Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur on February 9th, two senior devotees asked Srila Gaur Govind Swami why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu stayed in Jagannath Puri while narrating the pastime of Lord Krishna coming back to Vrindavan after a long separation and how he appeared in the form of Lord Jagannath. His divine grace, Srila Gaur Govind Swami Maharaj, departed from this world and entered into the divine leelas of Sri Krishna. Thank you. Hare Krishna.